Hey, what's up, everybody? And welcome back to another episode of Minecraft. And I, as you can see, I've finished this up. Yay! That's all done, and doesn't look quite as good as I hoped it would. But it definitely does the job. And considering I spent about 3 hours on this in total, I'm happy. Everything still works, still looks nice, got everything lit up. Let's take this out for a spin. I worked a bit on the paths here. I haven't been able to finish everything, but I worked a bit and widened the path quite a bit. Edited that a little. Some work here, connected this and this, and it all looks nice again. Is the general idea. And last episode I was like, why are there no mob drops? And I'm like, and then I realized that I turned the lights off, because when I was lagging, I was trying to reduce my entities, because I still got quite a few entities in my world here. So that was pretty simple, actually, just turned it back on. Everything's good now, and I guess in the last episode I forgot to check out the terracotta blocks. And also I think I figured out how to color your wings. This video has been recorded like just barely after last one, like 2 days or something like that. This is just a theory, but maybe you do them like banners. Maybe not. Unless they have to be new ones. Like brand new. I don't know then. Wrong one again. Never mind. Where's my clay? It's here. Don't have very much, do I? Can make half a stack in total. Well, just over half a stack, but I don't want to waste any more. So the terracotta, you just smelt hardened clay, with their respective colours, and I've got potatoes smelting in there, so I'll just leave that for now. Yeah, I haven't really got a plan for this episode. I want to check out the terracottas, but I need to wait a little bit for that, and I need to prepare to receive those terracottas as well. I need ink sacks. Ink sacks? Ink sacks? Come on, where are you? Squid, yay. Nice. Ha ha ha. I'm evil. Okay, that hurt. I should probably try to, like, get a bit more agility going on in my flying, because I always hit something, pretty much always. Got ink sacks. I only need it four, but that's fine. Yeah, it's gone now. So all you do is just re-smelt them, but it has to be coloured. You can't choose later, unfortunately. And what should I do? I want to start a new project, but I really don't have that much time this episode. I have 2 hours maximum. Like, that's the safe amount of time I have for today. Maybe 2.5. But that's time guaranteed. So let's just see if there's anything quick I can do here. Not really. The project is as on season 4 of DoomCraft, I was starting to dig that massive hole. I originally wanted to do it in this world, so that's the plan, to do it. But I need a good place to do it, so I need to find one first. So I was thinking around this area somewhere, but I do want to have for it to be like 1,000 blocks away or something like that. I want a second base, because this base, it's only laggy because it's got so many things there, and I need to find a place that doesn't have very many things so it doesn't lag. Oh yeah, we never finished this project, have we? That was a nice landing. Of course, no pressure plate. Okay. Yeah, we never finished this, and we probably never will, because I'm lazy. Yeah, and I also ran into a ravine there. Dude, I have so much stone here. I don't need to smelt anything ever. But anyways, let's go up a bit. Okay. If we go this way a bit more, we get the swamp, and I don't want the swamp. We get mountains. I don't want mountains. Ideally, I would do it in the jungle, but the nearest jungle that I found was like 32,000 blocks away. So there's just no way I'm going anywhere near that. I could do it in the desert, but preferably in a mesa if it's going to be a desert. There's always problems, okay? I'll always find a problem. Over here is my witch farm, so I can't do it anywhere near here. Otherwise, I'm going to start having problems. I should probably let my world load real quick. Oh yeah, I got the witch farm disabled. Don't remember why now. I think, yeah, it didn't work, that's why. But quite a bit of stuff here. Okay. Pretty sure this doesn't go anywhere afterwards. And also, I can't check out, like, I can't do the biome finder thing, because there's no new ones. There's, like, no updated ones, or none that come up first on your page, on your browser, I mean. So, it's, like, impossible to find one that is compatible with this version for me to find the right biome. Like, because this world was created in 1.8, so the start is, like, 1.8 there, but the newest stuff is here. And I'm not even sure that the seed is going to work the same. Okay. I probably have to do this off camera anyway. But could I do it in the savannah? I wonder. You know what? If I was to do it in a savannah, then I could do it where my big storage room is, because then I'm actually going to have a reason to go there. And there's a nice desert as well. That's where I'm going to go. So let's head back home, and then I'll start looking for a nice area. I came in from the wrong side somehow. I was going to go from there, but I ended up going from way over there. Oh, I got so disorientated. But anyway, let's use our little landing pad here, which we made. Nice. And now let's go through the portal after I clean some stuff up. Quickly, whilst I'm here, let's do two enchantments. Meh. Meh. Okay, waste of time. But let's go through the portal. I should probably set up another one over there sometime soon, because it bugs me now. And okay. Oh, I should have slept first. Uh-oh. There's four zombie people here. Oh, big lag spike. The world is still loading. One of them seems to have gone through the portal, which is not good stuff, because next time I see him, he's gonna be aggro. Oh, I'm in big trouble now. Okay, let's go to the storage room and sleep real quick, because I'm pretty sure I have a bed there. Okay. Good thing I made this back entrance, which I just failed to go through. Ooh, I accidentally did a double one there. Yes, I made it. Ooh, that's a lot of chests here. I tell you, that's enough for a lifetime. I've got quite a few good things around here. I've got some chicken, got a furnace crafting table. Okay, I think I should be able to stay here for a few hours without dying. Yeah, I definitely should. I have dirt, I've got some bread, golden apple, chicken, as I just said. Yeah, not bad. Got a few sticks, some iron, if I have to make tools for some reason. But, this is not why we're here. We're here to find a nice place to make a big circle. If you have any loads of dirt, just go to one of these pillars. Okay. We need to find a nice flat area. Preferably without rivers. Over here can work. Okay, that's a river. How wide would this be? So, okay, 240. Over to, not quite wide enough. It will be river just in the corners here, maybe. On the edge. Maybe not, actually. It might work. That bunny scared me. Rabbit foot? Nope. So hard to hit them. Nope. I swear there was a big one around here. Yeah, I want to build it next to the portal, otherwise that portal is just gonna be useless and it won't connect back to the original portal if I move it too far. But here's a much bigger area. Actually, no, it's not. I tell lies. This loads in. Yeah, this is still a bigger area. Did I check this one out? I have to have done that. That's a wooden pressure plate, pretty sure. Oh no, it's a stone. I have not been here yet. I'll take that. That. Ooh. And that. And that. And that's all that's worth taking. Okay, that was a pretty good thing. That I came here. Ooh, like a boss. I've definitely been to the other one. That's around here somewhere. Anyway, I'm rambling on. Okay, so I have found the perfect spot. It is right here. So we have our storage system over there, our portal over there, and I was like, well, why not build it right in between the two? That way, I don't have to move the portal far, and I'm still quite close to that. So, I've now got to make the parameters of this, which is 100 by 100, I'm pretty sure. Wait, hold on a sec. Will that be even or odd? Is the question. Let me go onto my little app on my phone, XIB Circles, and see what that will do. Okay, diameter. Oh, way too far. Okay, 100. Show circle. And that makes no good. So it must be 101 that I did back on the server. That looks more right now. Unless it was 75 by 75. I'm really not sure now. It was 100 by 100. Well, you know what? I'm just gonna go back and check the video, see what I said. Okay, so I went back on the video and it was actually 75 blocks, so that just makes life so much easier. Like so much. But I need to start by cutting down all these trees, because they're gonna get in the way. Oh, I got the hiccups. So yeah, most of this is gonna be done off camera, so I'm just gonna do nothing really. I'm gonna go work on something else that you might enjoy, but just keep in mind that I'm gonna be working on this mostly off camera. I'll probably come back to this in the start of next episode though. Actually, I'm going the wrong way. Yeah, see you back at base. Alright, so back at base now, I have cooked up some terracotta blocks, and this is what they look like, and FYI, they are oriental block-like things, because if I just place them like this, I can do all sorts of stuff, and they'll be facing in different directions. So, to make the pattern right, you kind of need to know how to place them. So this is the pattern. Pretty cool, I'd say. I think I can do it in reverse as well, and it will look pretty cool. Right, like this. And there's like several different patterns that you can do, actually. Waist crack. Yeah, you can do a pattern like that. Of course, you can do these patterns. There's just so many things you can do. There's like three different patterns in one block. Well, two, but three, if you count this thing. Then there's technically three patterns in one block, which I think is pretty damn cool. Like, for example, you could pretend that this is like some kind of special plate that you stand on. You can pretend this is the same but turned on. For example, you can make a hob, I guess. I don't know. And then this, I don't even know what that would be. But yeah, they're pretty cool. Definitely want to use these in my future builds. But they're just too bright, I'd say. Like, it's not something you would just add. Like, this is like an old kind of look. Like, medieval times, and then this is like 300 years later, kind of. No, I'm wrong. Medieval is 1,000, so 800 years later. And I guess I'd put this with clay because technically it is clay. But yeah, all in all, pretty cool. There are more colors, and each color has different patterns. So black is my favorite still. Can never change that. But well, I don't have enough of anything these days. I've got like 7 minutes left, so what should I do? I want to do something productive. Let me think. I have decided. I will make a lighthouse. That was a lot more concrete powder than I anticipated for, but I'll need it, it's fine. That's all of cement. Okay, I guess I'll use this up then to make this work properly. Damn, I need one more. Yeah, I need to go get a few more things, and I found out that this doesn't have a specific crafting recipe. That's pretty cool, actually. I don't need that, because I want 2 stacks exactly, because of my OCD. Then I need red dye, which I will get from somewhere. Let me get some sand first. Something I never thought I'd say, but I need more gravel. Okay. I only need a stack of this stuff, I think. Keep this looking natural though. Good. And let me go get, let me steal some red dye from my firework workshop, because I'm not using that at all right now. Whoa, overshot. Okay, now where is my red dye? Got lots of dyes. I did this in a specific order so that I don't get confused and I never learnt the order. Okay, good. I'll just make it down here. Okay. Die. I need more gravel, I can't make it down here. Okay. And turn it all into concrete. Whoops. This is like the most boring process ever. But it's much faster than what I was doing last episode. Wait, I know why it's not working, because I don't have haste over here. I thought it reached here for some reason. So let me go to near my haste, close to my haste beacon. And it should work now. Okay. No, concrete doesn't break super fast, I forgot. So it doesn't really matter. Oh wait. No, this is efficiency 5. Never mind. It does seem slightly faster, but that might just be because I'm talking. Yes! Oh, that voice crack. Wow. But anyway, let's start building the lighthouse. I'm not sure how big it's gonna be, but this is gonna be the center right over here. You know what? Let's move it over by one. Okay, so it's gonna be the center, so 1, 2, 3, 4. Let's have one more. 1, 2, 3, 4. And that doesn't work. I went wrong somewhere. Probably like this. Yeah, it is. Now, should I have it as basic as that? Or should I make it slightly better by making it go out by one more? I do have just enough space to have it go up by one more, so that's what I'm gonna do. How I wish they added vein miner to normal Minecraft, that would make it so much better. My aim is slightly weird today, if you haven't noticed. For me, it's like really weird to aim. That's because earlier today I played Counter-Strike Necks and Zombies for like 4 hours. Well, that's an over-exaggeration, 2 hours. And like the aim is slightly different there, like pointing, and I'm like, how do I do it in Minecraft? So yeah, it's a bit weird. I got everything messed up now. All of my controls, because in CSNX, no, NZ, crouch is control, and shift, I'm pretty sure, just slows you down. I'm not even sure what shift does. I don't think it does anything. But yeah, it can be quite confusing. I need just one more block out, and then this will be perfect. Okay. Of course, I'll probably finish this off camera as well. How has that not gone back to grass yet? Okay. One, two, three, four, five, like this. Yes, like this. Now I think I'm happy with that. Yeah, I'm happy. Let's keep it like this. So where should the entrance be? I think it shall be from here, so have the door there. And perfect, it takes exactly half a stack for each layer. I'm gonna need to get way more concrete. But anyway, this should do for now. Gonna do it in twos. So that'll be just enough for 4 layers in total. Not 4, 8. Okay, I'm gonna do them with you guys, and then I'll do the rest off camera. Well, not off camera, like after the episode, if I still want to. But I needed to put something here anyway. It was gonna be either some kind of cabin or this, and this made more sense. Okay. I don't know how high I want it to be. Maybe about up to half of that tower. Maybe even taller. I don't know, because I looked at some pictures and the lighthouses were pretty tall. Also, I want to start a new project, which I'll probably never finish, and I'll probably only work on it for like half an hour. But I'm kind of enthusiastic about it right now. And I know someone's already done this before, but they didn't finish the whole world. Basically, the idea is to copy the whole world in a 1-to-1 ratio in Minecraft. In the real life world, 1-to-1 ratio in Minecraft. Pretty hard to do, actually. I tried doing something like that before and I failed, but I think I could do it eventually if you like give me enough time, like 3 years or something. Then I could do at least the whole of England, although someone's done much bigger stuff, so that kind of puts me off because I know I'll never be able to do that much work. Yeah, this is a pretty nice start to the lighthouse. And it is unfortunately time to end the episode, so thank you very much for watching. Hope you enjoyed it. Yeah. See you in the next one. Bye bye. I just flew around my whole world, or the big island that I'm on, to find like 10 pieces of gravel, and they were right here for me to collect. Just wow. Bye!